weird from everybody else.
I think what made him weird was the fact that how he said it, when he said mother deceives funeral small, faithfully yours.
What about that though? Like, what about that makes it stand out to like...
It's just like, he says it like it's another day and just something else to do, like the next day. It's something not out of this world. It's like totally normal.
What was the question again?
What in the first chapter makes him a little weird?
Oh, he uses like his mother's death and as an excuse to not work. So like, your mother's death is just an excuse to not...
Yeah, the whole fact that he's like talking about his boss, saying that his boss looked a little bothered by it, and he said, it's not my fault. Where did he say it?
It's in the first page, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I think.
Like in the middle?
I even said it's not my fault.
Yeah, but he wasn't too happy about it.
So I highlighted something that I want you guys to like, what do you guys think about it? I highlighted for now, it's almost as if Mama weren't dead. What do you guys think about that line?
Maybe he's in denial about it.
Or nothing has really changed that she, now that she's dead.
Yeah, maybe he doesn't just like process the whole idea that she's dead, and he just like doesn't like process it into his head.
Nah, I think he just doesn't like, nothing's changed. So there's no difference.
What do you guys think?
I agree with Juan, because like he had said earlier that probably because they weren't like really close, so that's why to him, like, it doesn't matter, it doesn't make a difference.
What makes you think that they're more close? What in the story?
Well, I mean, he put her like in a little home, so that's what I, well, I mean, it doesn't really talk about like before that, so we really can't.
I mean, like he said, he put her in the home for like,
but it was for her benefit, though, yeah. She didn't have money, like, he didn't have money to support her,
and also, like, he wouldn't talk to her like as much in the house because he said that when she got there to the home, she was sad, like, she would cry if she'd been taken out, if like they take her out because she had friends there. So he wanted her, at the same time, it was a benefit to her too because she made friends. And she didn't have like really anyone to talk to when she was living with him. So I think it was like not a bad idea. And he didn't do it like in a mean way. It's not like he was trying to get rid of her and like he didn't want to see her anymore.
What do you think?
About what is it?
About like...
pretty much... Their relationship.
Well, I just think that he really didn't like care about his mom. I think he didn't really. I don't really think he put her like in the home because he couldn't support her. Probably he just didn't want to be with her.
Why did he want to be there? Why do you think he didn't want to be with her? Like, what in the text did he say that?
Where?
Sure. Why do you think he didn't want to be with her?
Cause like from the beginning, it just seems like he didn't care. Like, you're here, my mom died today or yesterday, maybe, I don't know. He really doesn't care if she was dead or not. I mean, she was probably dead for him already.
Okay. Let's move on. We're getting too much time on one question.
We can talk about the funeral.
Well, I mean, he doesn't even pay attention to it, does he?
He was paying attention
to the old man.
He doesn't want to see, like, her mom.
Which part was talking about the funeral, where he's, like, in there, sitting down with those people, or when he's walking?
The entire thing, the whole funeral experience thing. He wasn't even, like, thinking about his mother the entire time. He was, like, thinking about other people there. He would be, like...
He was annoyed.
I heard a strange noise that I could figure out what it was. He was, like somewhere else, like not even thinking about his mother.
And when they asked if he wanted to see his mom, he's like, no. He's like, why? He's like, I don't know.
He was kind of an asshole though to the people that were mourning, like, like grieving. Because I remember one part, like on page 11, he was like, she sniffled a lot, then she finally shut up. I didn't feel drowsy anymore.
And then he says, where is this? No, it was all these people now not making a sound that was getting on my nerves.
Like, who says that?
Especially on your... Oh, God.
That's crazy.
God. The man that that was Damien's mother.
Thomas?
No.
Thomas Perez. You can obviously see that like he didn't really talk to her because he didn't know this guy that was there were like really close.
Yeah, and he didn't even know her. Yeah,
like even the man pregnant, not even her own son.
Yeah. He was rushing trying to get to the place.
Oh yeah.
Even though it was fucking high.
At the beginning of the story, how does he feel about the son?
He doesn't like it?
He doesn't like it. Towards the end, doesn't he start liking it?
No, he reaches like,
What do you guys think about his girlfriend or his mistress?
Mary?
Just for sex.
She's very horny.
Oh, God.
Yeah, well, he always talks about her breasts. And how like how good he looked.
So do you think he cares about her a little?
No.
Why? Why do you think he cares about her?
Because like when the power says if she would if he would marry her, and he says like
it's
in like 8:42 I think.
41. That even Mary came by to see me and asked me if I wanted to marry her. I said it didn't make any difference to me in that we could if she wanted to.
How do you guys feel about that? It kind of seems like he doesn't care about anything. He has nothing to care for. He's carefree.
I think it makes no difference to him. Like, if he would get married, it would be like whatever to him. It's not, he has no goal. He doesn't want anything. So, like, having something, it means nothing to him.
But he has no ambition. In the boss city, you don't have any ambition.
Yeah, he doesn't want anything.
Hey, Gustavo, what do you think?
Well, I think the Marcel has, like, a lot of, like, reason. Like, it really doesn't make any difference. So, like, I don't know. I think I would kind of, like, relate to him with it.
Why?
Like, I wouldn't really care either. And also, like, on the part where it talks about where his mom died, like, I get it, like, she died, okay, like, if you're crying, nothing's gonna matter, like, whatever you do, nothing's gonna matter. If you cry, she's not gonna come back, so just, like, accept it and move on.
Well, it
looks
like it didn't even hurt him, though.
It wouldn't hurt,
I mean, I would understand if it was somebody else, like, he didn't know, but, like, that's her mom. But I guess he probably wasn't close with her. That's the only thing I can think of that made him like not react or feel sad or cry or something is because he wasn't close to her. But other than that, I think he should have reacted in some type of way.
Do you think Marcel's mom wanted to make like a new life in that where she was? New place?
In the house? Yeah. In the little house.
Like she wanted to do her life all over.
I don't understand your question.
It's because you said a full sentence, but then you
were like, you understand him.
What about the
what about the whole dog situation?
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. The whole dog.
What do you guys think about that? I mean,
the old man's lonely, so just keeps the dog.
What about what's it called? Marcel's reaction to like,
him beating the dog
and him like, okay.
Doesn't he find it interesting?
That's all he ever says. Like the same way that how
Raven
beats his girlfriend, he's like, oh, it's fun. I found the whole situation very interesting. Oh, right here. On page 32. Mm-hmm. He was like, he wanted to know what I thought of the whole thing. I said I didn't think anything but that it was interesting.
What do you think about that?
What do you mean by interesting? The whole situation was interesting.
I think when he means interesting, like, he finds it strange, but yet he doesn't really care. Like, oh, you know, that was interesting. it caught his attention for like a second. But then after that, it was like, I'll go on with my life.
Why do you think he doesn't like cops?
Remember he said he didn't like cops.
Yeah.
What about Sundays? Like, you know how he doesn't like
Sundays? Because then he just started like outside on his window.
Yeah. Why do you think Sunday is like such a big deal? Like, well, I hate Sundays.
Well, I don't like Sundays either. Because the next day, I mean, like,
school.
So I'm guessing the next day for him is like work. Why he doesn't like Sundays. Maybe just like doesn't like them.
Gustavo, why do you think, you know, he agreed when Raymond asked him to write the letter for his mistress?
Well, I think he just agreed because like he has
no reason not to.
Yeah. He has no reason not to, and like he doesn't have anything else to do.
Plus, the man gave him food, so why not?
And then, and also probably because Raymond said, like, he wanted to be pals or something, so he was like...
Like, if it was you, like, would you be like, oh, I want to spit in this girl's face when you want to help me?
Nah. He just said, write the letter. I'll write a letter. If he were to tell me to write a letter, I'll do it.
Eric. Whatever, you know what I mean. What do you think?
Okay. Oh. Well, I mean, didn't he just kill him because the sun got in his eyes?
No, no, he shot him at first and then.
No, but he shot
him. He stopped because it was like.
Before.
Well,
he
shot
no, the sun got in his eyes.
No, it was an accidental.
Yeah.
The first shot was accidental.
Yeah. No,
no, no, no, no, no,
the first thing you shot him.
No, what?
I don't know what page it is. It has to be.
Is it like chapter 3, chapter part 2?
Chapter...
Like
the,
when it begins?
Right here. As soon as he saw me, he sat up a little and put his hand in his pocket.
What page?
50, I want to say 57 and on.
Yeah.
Oh, look, it's right here, 59.
Okay, go. Read.
Alright, just say.
Start from the scorching blade slashed at my eye.
What?
The scorching blade slashed at
my eye. No, not right there.
No.
Look.
Okay.
Look.
That's where it starts.
Right here, look.
That's where it starts.
Yeah. Look, go to the top where he's like. It was this burning, which I couldn't stand anymore.
Where?
Over here at the top.
Very top.
Okay, I got it.
And then you move forward.
See, but then he says, I knew that it was stupid that I wouldn't get the sun off me by stepping forward, but I took one step forward, and this time without getting up, the arrow drew his knife and held it up to me in the sun.
The light shot off of the steel, and it was like a long flashing blade cutting at my throat.
The scorching blade slashed at my eyelashes and stabbed at my stinging eyes. That's when everything began to reel.
Okay, and then then I fired 4 more times at the motionless body. The 4 more times had nothing to do with the sun in his eye. It was the first time.
No, look, my whole being tense and squeezed my hand around the revolver.
The first time that he shot was an accident. But when he continuously shot at the body, not moving, that wasn't an accident anymore.
That was him
intentionally shooting at the person.
Also, the first one, they were all like the same. Just that he stopped because there was like sweat in his face, so he just went like this and then. He shot 4 more times.
Okay, that was not accidental.
None of them were accidental. Not even the first one. The first one was like also the same.
Okay. So what do you guys think about that though? Because we're arguing.
Oh, yeah. The whole fact that he shot him 4 more times.
Why do you think he shot him 4 more times? After he wasn't moving. He said,
well, I mean, the first time he shoots
at the motionless body.
Yeah, he's shooting at like a body that's already on the ground.
Just to have fun.
You know what? Okay, the first time he shot him, right?
Yeah,
when
it was
he shot him.
Sun.
Okay, doesn't matter.
Yeah,
okay, yes.
Gone.
Yes.
Because he was It was because of the sun. It was like to the sun.
I don't know.
Because the sun really to the sun.
Okay, point is, all right, he's on the ground. He's dead. Why do you think
he shot him four more times?
Honestly, I think it was to release something that he didn't really know was there. Like, you know how you just get so stressed sometimes that you have to find, like, something to do? Like, something to get it out.
I think he was just letting out the whole fact, like, of, like, you know how, like, it goes back to his mother about the whole sun thing?
The funeral?
Yeah, the funeral and stuff. I think, like, this is where, like, his snap came in. And he shot him four more times.
Or probably he just
shot him
for fun.
I was like, that's just fun.
Yeah, he was just like, he's hitting him four more times. I don't think it was because, like...
So you think he just did it just to do it because he didn't give a fuck about anything?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Well, yeah, he just did it because, like, he already shot him once.
What
other explanation can there be? I can't think of anything else.
He had anger in him or something. He was like emotional stress.
Okay, let's move on. What do you guys think about in the same page where it says, and it was like knocking four quick times on the door of unhappiness?
That's what I think what made him shoot him continuously was that there was something like psychologically, like there wasn't something right, like he wasn't coping with everything the way usually people do.
Also, doesn't believe after he killed the guy, he doesn't really take into the in fact that he actually killed the person because he didn't take anything seriously when they were
interrogating him. He didn't think it was serious because
it was so much close to the TV shows he's used to. He's like, I was gonna shake his hand, but like, oh, okay.
What do you think about his first child?
I don't like his child. The end of the story.
I mean, why do you guys think that they brought up like his mother so much? Like, what does that have to do?
What it has to do is they thought that, okay, you know how like he killed the guy four times. They're trying to say that he had no type of like
guilt,
sympathy, or he just like it was wrong. Something was wrong with him. Cause like the whole idea with his mother is that he didn't feel anything when his mother died. Why should he feel something for someone he just killed? So
he would do it again.
Yeah, he would do it again, and it wouldn't matter to him. You know, the whole point of trying to save a person is because, like, not going to the death penalty and stuff is because they can change, right? So my idea is that they try to prove that he's not a person that could change.
Do you think he changes though? I mean, after, you know, he talks about how he starts remembering, you know, when he's in jail, and he starts remembering all this stuff that he really didn't pay attention to until it was taken away from him. So do you think that's a personal change, or do you think it was just like, oh, well, I know I'm going to be here forever, or what do you think, like, about that?
It's more of a personal change because eventually he's gonna know he's gonna be forgotten, so it's like, let me just might as well reflect, but there's no really point of it because not many people are close to him, so there's not gonna be a connection to him, to people's lives.
What do you think about that?
I don't know what the question.
Like, what do you think when he talks about, like, oh, he starts remembering about how the sun beating on his skin and remembering, you know, what it was like to be outside of these cold bars. Do you think him remembering and stuff like that was like a personal change that he had?
Well, I mean, I don't see a change. I mean, he's just like...
He just described himself, but it's not like... I don't think it was a personal change at all. Because in the end, like, it doesn't like... seem like he like regrets what he did or anything like that.
Could I go to page 77? It says, I used to wait patiently until Saturday to hold Maria. Maria's wadding my arms and says, Mama's ideas. And she often repeated that after a while you could get used to anything. What do you guys think about that? Getting used to anything?
He got used to doing it.
I don't think he got used to it. I think he was more like, you know what, I did do this myself. No one helped me. And he's starting to remember like the words that his mom actually said.
Do you think anyone can get used to anything at any time?
I mean, it depends. I think it's like sometimes when you feel like there's nothing else to do, I think you at one point have to realize that, you know, he has to get used to it.
What about you? Do you need to get used to anything? Or what do you mean by that?
If I would be used to anything? Mm-hmm.
Well, like, you know how he says, Mama's ideas, she often repeated, after a while, you can get used to anything. The first months were hard, but in fact, the effort I had to make helped pass the time. For example, I was tortured by the desire of woman.
What do you guys think about